Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. In this video, I'm going to be explaining the curves adjustment because it's one of the most confusing but the most powerful and easy to use adjustments once you understand a few things. In a previous video, I looked at levels adjustments, and if you haven't already seen this, I really recommend you watch it. I'll put the details in the video information below. One of the things that we looked at in the previous video was this image. And it tries to explain image tones because this is very important when it comes to understanding how the curves work. What it shows here is two different representations that you might find in different software. Basically, down at this end of the strip, we've got pure black, and over at this end, we go to pure white. How those tones are represented in software tends to be using one of two approaches. The first one is the tonal values here from 0 running up to 255, with 128 being a mid-tone grey. The other scheme tends to use percentages, which runs from 0% up to 100%, and effectively is the amount of brightness that you have in the image. So at 0% brightness, it would be black, whereas at 100% brightness, you'd have white. And at 50% brightness, again, you've got mid-tone grey. Now, this is all very important for understanding levels, but it also improves our understanding of the curves tool. So let's go and have a look at the curves adjustment. Now, I've already added a curves adjustment over here to my image, and I'll just display the properties window. And that shows you the curve that you're probably used to seeing. Now, a lot of people simply go about adding points onto the curve and adjusting it like so. And there is some understanding of how it works, but not a great deal. In this video, I want to explain to you exactly what's happening on the curves tool, how to read it, and how to understand how it really works. So the first thing you need to understand is that there's two axes for this. The horizontal axis is all about what we call the input values. So these are the tones that you see in the image now. And over on the left side, we've got pure black, and over on the right side, we've actually got pure white. And you can see that represented by the bands here running from black through to white, just as we had on the gradient previously that I showed. Now, as I say, these are the input values, so the tones that you see in this image. If I click on this point adjuster here, as I move my cursor over a point in the image, you can see that the tonal value is being shown on this curve line here. So if I move to a darker point, you can see it's further to the left. If I move to a bright white point, it's over on the right of the curve. Now, the curve at the moment is a straight line, and the reason for that is this other axis, this y-axis here that we've got runs vertically. Again, that shows from black through to white. And what it represents is the changed value of a tone in the image once you've adjusted it. Let me show you how that's going to work. So I'm going to click on the central point in the curve. And you'll see down here that that has an input value of 128. Remember what I said, that's mid-tone grey. We also have an output value that's identical, 128. If we read this, we can see that the central point between 0 and 255 is 128. The output value is also 128. So what this is saying is, at the moment, the curve's having no effect. So a mid-tone grey value of 128 is being translated into an output value of 128 as well. So there's no change. If I move that up by one square, you'll notice that my input value is 128, but my output value is now 154. So the mid-tone greys in this image are now being turned into something that's lighter, and as a result, the overall image looks lighter. You can see that if I turn the curves effect on and off. Now, one thing I should mention is that you've probably seen lots of little squares on my curve background here. And you're probably looking at a curves adjustment that has only four squares. If you hold down your Alt key or your Option key and then click on the grid, you can toggle it between having four squares and having 10 squares. I prefer the 10 squares because I think it gives me a better understanding of how far I've moved something. So let's go back to reading this grid a little bit further. We've already said the input value of 128 is where I've added point. We've gone to 154 with it for the output value, makes everything lighter. And the reason it makes everything lighter is because if you look along the curve now, every point is above the original diagonal line, so every tone in the image becomes brighter in some way. Now, as we get nearer to the black point, the increase in value from where the line was previously and the new line is smaller. So the curve adjustment that we've added has less effect on the darker tones. And the further away we get from the center point, the less the effect is, until we get to black, where we're having no effect at all. The same is true at the other end, where we go to white. Now, we can also take this level adjustment that you see here, and we can move it to the left. And that will actually move the tones, the brightest tones in the image, to white. And again, as before, if you hold down your Alt key or your Option key, as you move this, you can see the areas of the image that start to clip. So we can introduce some very limited clipping if we want to. Now notice up here the point that's been added. At the moment, this shows an input value of 242, so something that wasn't quite pure white before now becomes, in the output value, 255, pure white. And you can do the same with black. Now if I move that into the towards the centre, hold down my Alt key, I can see where the clipping starts in the shadows. Again, what I've got here is an input value of 6, so something that wasn't quite pure black, now has an output value of 0, or pure black. You can move it the other way and actually grab that point and move it up. And when you do that, you take the black out of the image. So a value of 0, or something that should be black, actually becomes 26, something that isn't black at all, it's just dark grey. Now let's look what happens if you move something below the line. So here we've got point of 77 as the input, and that now has a new value of 100. We can drag that back down to our original output value. Now, I'm finding it difficult to actually make the two match. So one thing you can do, if you want to work precisely, is say 77 and 77, so you can actually enter the values in the input and output fields. Now look what that's done to the curve though. Whilst it has moved the curve, the original curve, back down to its starting point, it's actually moved the curve as well down here to darker values. So if you want to stop that from happening, you've got to add another curve point and move that back up again, just to maintain the straight part of the line here. It's also added a lot of contrast into the image. And when you add contrast into the image by working on the RGB channel, it ends up saturating the image. So look how the saturation has increased here as a result of adjusting the curve. Now all those adjustments are too strong, but the idea here is that you understand what the curves tool is doing and how to read it. And it's all about these input and output values again, and understanding that this horizontal axis represents the input value, whilst this vertical axis represents the output value. And once you understand that, you understand how to use the curves tool. Now let's have a quick look in a couple of other applications that also have curves. This time, I've got the image open in Affinity Photo. And we can see over here in the studio panels on the right, we have a curves adjustment. And I can add a new curves adjustment just by clicking the option here. The tools on this are slightly different from the Photoshop version I showed you earlier, but the underlying principle of how this works is exactly the same. You can pick the channel that you want to adjust, in this case the master channel, or you can pick the individual red, green, blue channels, or an alpha channel. When we pick the master channel, all we're doing is we're adjusting all three of the channels, the colour channels, red, green and blue, to the same level. And that is what maintains the colours in the image. If I adjusted one of the channels in isolation, it would change the colour balance of the image. Again, we have a horizontal axis, and we can put a point on that and move it up. Now what we can't see is the input and output values for the image, but the overall adjustment remains the same. You've got this input value, mid-tone, moving up to a lighter value here. And again, we can pick the curve at either end and we can move that in to adjust the brightest tones. So the principles of the curves tool and the adjustment remains the same, even though this is a simpler version than the Photoshop one. Let's take a look in another adjustment tool. Here we are this time in Capture One, and I've taken the curve from the side panel and just pulled it out so you can see what we're doing. Now this is a simpler curve than the others, but it still has all this power. So again, I can adjust the RGB channel, which is the red, green and blue channels, or I can pick the luminosity channel, the red channel, green channel or blue channel. Again, I have an input and an output value, and I also have a picker tool which allows me to pick and add a point based on any point in the image. You don't have to use the picker tool though, you can actually just use and click the point on the curve that you want to adjust. So again, I can add my mid-tone input value of 128 and I can move that up to lighten the curve. And here we can see the input value for the point that I've got selected down here, and the output, which is on the vertical scale. So again, the curve is working just the same, even though it's slightly different in Capture One. And it's the same across all the different tools that you use. The curve works in the same way. So once you understand how to use it in one, you can apply that knowledge to the other editing tools, allowing you to quickly understand and improve your images. I hope you found this useful. I will be publishing future videos covering other common tools. If you've got any suggestions about good tools to cover, please let me know in the comments below. It'll be really helpful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.